one belongs to the Alexandra Palace. This is the curtain raiser, the undercard before the main event. But this is arguably the biggest game in these two young men's career. Aaron Munker, familiar surname, of course, is the son of the veteran professional Colin Monk. And just to repeat what Dave Clark has said, the best of 11 legs, first to six then, will be crowned world under 21 champion. Van Gerwen, who's already appeared on this Alexandra Palace stage in the first round of the World Championship, doubles were his shortfall on that occasion. He was beaten in the first round, which was a major disappointment for Van Gerwen. And it was the doubles that really proved to be his undoing, because he is a fine, naturally gifted player. There was a time when Van Gerwen was actually at the same level as Adrian Lewis. As many experts' eyes, they thought that Van Gerwen and Lewis were progressing at the same rate. Here we are on finals night, Lewis in the world final, Van Gerwen making do with a place in the world under 21 final. Rod Harrington's made his way alongside me into the commentary box. And Rod, two fine young players, and good to see them up on the big stage.
Yeah, I think it's great, Nigel. I mean, the PDC is ostensibly going to support youth darts now. We need to find the new, you know, Phil Taylor and Gary Andersons and Dennis Priestley's, and this is the way to do it. I mean, Van Gerwen has been around a long time, though, for a youngster, and should be used to the big crowd, should be used to the big stage and TV. But this young man, Aaron Monk, comes from the Andover Academy, and they're starting to breed a lot of good players.
Well, I did make the point as you were making your way down to commentary that there was a time when this man was compared to Lewis as the same generation coming through the system, and perhaps at a similar rate of knots, and many expected Van Gerwen to be on a level with Adrian Lewis, but it's just not happened for Michael Van Gerwen, Rod, on a consistent enough basis.
I was out in Holland a few years ago, Nige, and he played, lost to Barney in the final there. And I watched this kid and I thought, if he was a kid, I thought, this is an unbelievable talent. This guy was going to take the darts world by storm. But when he came over, he just hasn't done it.
Well, if you've just joined us here at the Alexandra Palace, it's about 20 minutes or so until the world final. Adrian Lewis and Gary Anderson, you're watching the World Under 21 Championship Final here right now. First to six legs, so it's a quick fire format, and Aaron Monk is set on a finish of 78. So around about 20 minutes or so to the main event, AD Lewis and Gary Anderson in a final which everybody is predicting to be an absolute classic. Make sure you stay with us throughout the course of the night. Now, Aaron Monk needed treble 18 there. Which way will he go now? With Van Gerwen breathing down his neck on 102, it will be a tall order for Van Gerwen on the 22. Form that he's showing right now, but he can still take this out. 102 he needs, with Monk sat on 56. Chance for Aaron Monk now, Rod.
Yeah, and this will settle the young man down. He can take this out, 16 for double top. This is big darts in this first leg at this short format for young Monkey. I mean, that nice clinical finish, that will settle him down. You know, Michael now, he knows he's got to win this over this short format. Cannot give you a throwaway in the second leg.
44. Aaron Monk from Basingstoke. They actually reached the final with the last 16 onwards at Barnsley to actually get this far. Aaron Monk in the semi-finals got the better of Lewis Baines 4-2. Van Gerwen got the better of a fellow Dutchman, Benito van der Paas, 4-1 in the semi-finals. This is the final of the World Under 21 Championship, and Van Gerwen, far from fluent and far from his normal self, because we know what a naturally gifted player he is. Great to watch on occasions, and still a great occasion for both players, Rob.
Yeah, huge news. As I said, Michael's been up there a lot of times before, but this is for Aaron Monk the start of perhaps a wonderful career. You know, in a few years' time, he could be up on that big stage playing 20 minutes' time. And you know, talking about that final night, I don't think I've ever witnessed so much atmosphere and anticipation for a final. I mean, it's going to be huge.
Absolutely right. Michael Van Gerwen, Mighty Mike. Again, comparisons with the other quick-fire Dutch players, Jelle Klassen, Vincent van der Voorn, who had a terrific World Championship, and the latest odds for the World Final, which is coming up in a few moments' time. Adrian Lewis, Gary Anderson, head head to head, first to seven sets. And look at this from Aaron Monk. That's the first 10-40 of the match for Aaron Monk.
Yeah, Michael just cannot find the range. And what happens with these very quick throwers, Noyes? Once they've lost the range with the first dart, they've lost the range with all three. They just cannot adapt. They cannot move around the board. And if he doesn't find it very quickly, then Aaron's going to run away. And this is a beautiful setup from Monk.
Well, if Aaron Monk can break Van Gerwen's throw here, it'll be a massive break of throw in the context of a short format game.
60.
Now, which way will he go? Will he go 8 for tops? Or will he go 16, double 16? Tops he needs now for Aaron Monk for a 2-0 lead. Not too far away.
8.
Well, he'll be disappointed that he didn't take that out, Ron. He will be, but realistically, the way Michael's been playing, I was going to say he might not take this out. He's missed the treble 19, but that was close. But Aaron there, he's got three clear darts on his double top. What he doesn't want to do is put this one on the top wire because his darts seem to lay down a little bit. Put it straight in. You can see what it means to him. And it's big money for these youngsters tonight. Absolutely. £10,000 to the winner of the PDC Unicorn World Under 21 Championship. £5,000 to the runner up. And Aaron Monk with a break of throw has a 2-0 lead here. Dad Colin will be delighted. As with any professional player in any professional sport with a famous father, brother, it always has to be mentioned in any profile that Aaron is the son of Colin Monk. And of course he played in the UK Open at Bolton in the summer. As we continue the build-up, set betting now, Lewis 7-0, 80-1. How Adrian would love that.
I think only chances will grab as Aaron puts his first 118 on a match. I mean, that really will fire him up now. Michael is really up against the wall already. But you were saying about the father. I mean, that's why Aaron's got such a lovely throw. You know, Colin has really said, look, this is the way you throw dart. This is the way the top players. And he's got it as he's filling this up again. Delightful darts from Aaron Monk.
He's playing well here, isn't he? He's on a finish of 87 for a 3-0 lead. It'd be halfway to victory. Van Gerwen knows that he's up against it here. Aaron Monk sitting on 87 now.
Do you know what, an all night, he looks so cool, doesn't he? Doesn't look like he's panicking. There's not sweat running off his face, which is a sign of big nerves. He's really calm, collected, and now you can't see him giving the game up from here, but this game, as we know, Nige, can turn on a sixpence or on one dart.
Tops for Monk for 3-0. Oh, delightful finishing. He's 60% to the double, Aaron Monk, and this man hasn't had one shot at a double yet. Terrific stuff from Aaron Monk, playing beautifully. 81st in the PDC Order of Merit, 50 places below mighty Michael Van Gerwen. Fine display. And Aaron Monk has the chance to become a world champion here in the Under 21 final. Remember, Adrian Lewis and Gary Anderson standing by.
43.
They'll be on stage in a short while doing battle for the Ladbrokes.com World Darts Championship in an eagerly awaited showdown between two players who are quick fire, spectacular, and desperate to win a world title for the first time in their career.
Yeah, certainly the two rawest talents in the game that have finally stepped up to the mark. We've always talked about what they can do. This time they've delivered it, Nigel. And as I said, it's going to be a great spectacle. The anticipation is incredible, not only from the crowd, but from, you know, all the staff, the Sky staff and the PDC staff. Everyone is looking forward to it.
85.
Yeah, everybody I've spoken to today as well. Absolutely. Looking forward to the action. Van Gerwen finally finding a little bit of form here in the Under 21 final with a nice 140. That's his second of the match, yet to hit a 180. This young man, Aaron Monk, has hit two 180s so far. Has that 3-0 lead and is a tidy player. Very impressive. Saw him at Bolton in June in the UK Open. Lost to Dennis Evans there. And he's got a great future, Aaron Monk, for sure. Double 16 for Van Gerwen now. He's back in business. He gets his first leg on the board.
but he only holds his throw there. Yeah, what Aaron's got to do is hold his throw now, and he can't lose the match. Poor leg for him, but he knows that Michael's going to have to break him twice. And do you know what I like about it? What a lovely rhythm he's got, guys. You know, when you're going to teach people, and you say, look, you know, don't waste darts, like I say about Lady Lewis, don't waste that third dart. You look at Aaron Monk's throw, and that's going to come from his dad. You know, you don't do this, you don't do that, you do this, son. And you can see this, it's a lovely throw, it comes right back to that right eye, he sights it beautifully, comes back to the right eye, and then just a good strong release.
And very exciting.
Yeah, and the rhythm, it doesn't panic a dart.
That's exactly what Rod Harrington's talking about there. Van Gerwen, too quick for his own good in many experts' 60. Eyes. What's your thought on that, Rod?
Yeah, it is too quick, it is a good release, but the speed of the second and third dart that follows that first, if that first is not right, the other two will follow wherever it is. Sometimes, you know, if you're just slowing up a bit, you're going to be more consistent. And, you know, there's something that Michael's going to have to look at, as in Jelle Klassen as well, because they're just a tad too quick.
Nice darts from Van Gerwen, and he has an opportunity here to break back. Best of 11 legs then to win the World Under 21 final. And don't forget, Gary Anderson and Adrian Lewis, the main event standing by in a mouth-watering world final. Van Gerwen on 161, treble 17 for Bull. And he goes back up the board. Now, a real challenge for Aaron Monk to hold his throw.
Well, that treble three could be crucial, because when Van Gerwen comes back, I'm only going to dart at the bullseye. So if Aaron Monk, tell him even a 95 will do him. Now, don't miss a big number. He may go 25, because that'll give him two darts at double top. Well, he's going to get two darts at a double, whatever. So now, crucial 81 for Van Gerwen. Wants double 12.
69.
Oh, double prop looks again for Van Gerwen. It has to be said, he had a nightmare in the first round of the World Championship. Double 10 for Aaron Monk. Oh, that's how to finish. He's a very, very tidy player, Aaron Monk. 4-1 ahead. And that will hurt Van Gerwen, because this man knows he should have broken back there. Now he's holding his throw. And, well, Van Gerwen blew the opportunity. And his doubles, his finishing, let him down in the first round of the senior competition.
Yeah, Aaron Monk, 67% on doubles, 4 out of 6. Van Gerwen only on 33%. And then we have coming up in about 20 minutes, Adrian Lewis against Gary Anderson. The quickest and highest scoring game
57.
We will have seen for a few years. That's for sure. Anderson, 5-ton plus averages on his way to the final. And Adrian Lewis not far behind him. So we are really in for a massive final.
Aaron Monk is within 2 legs 41. Of becoming a world champion at the age of 20. Lewis and Anderson, one of those will be crowned world champion for the first 58. Time tonight. What a night at the Alexandra Palace. And it's coming immediately after this match. Aaron Monk averaging 82 almost.
47.
And Van Gerwen 82 and a half.
Well, in the final, as you can see in the caption, the 180 is 29 or less, 11, 30 or more evens. If that final goes to 12 sets, you've got to say it's going to go over the way they've been playing.
Yeah. For fun. 180s for fun. Crowd are giving good order to these 96. Two players. They are enjoying this, but they know the main event is just around the corner. Van Gerwen desperate to hold his throw. Sets himself up for 90.
Well, Aaron will be looking for a 140 because he knows he's hitting his doubles. A 140 will give him a dart at double top, which has been his favourite. Now he just lay it on that second dart. Oh, that's unlucky. He did nearly exactly what I asked him to do, but he's just taken the momentum off that dart.
Nicely done by Michael Van Gerwen. Tops for the finish. The bullseye worked a treat. And he's just hanging on in there. 4-2. Aaron Monk leads here. But if he holds his throw, then quite clearly, he is going to go on and be crowned World Under 21 champion and win the darts. And turn 40 is a lovely way to start, Rod.
Yeah, I have to say, you know, we call it shape, we call it form, and Aaron Hunt's rhythm is absolutely perfect. You know, he's in a major final on a major stage for his first time, and he's conducted himself extremely well. So he comes out the Andover Academy, and they are 60. Breed is not a great word, but it is the right word. They're breeding some great young dart players now.
Yeah, the PDC announced yesterday how closely they're going to be working with the youth tour, of course, and I know that's something that you're very close to, Rod.
Yeah, I managed to get a lot of money out of Mr. Hearn on the board. A bit of a fight to get money out of his pocket, but we managed to get $60,000 for next year. So an extensive youth tour coming up.
What about the world final? Who is going to get the most 180s? Lewis or Anderson?
171.
Well, that's a hard one to call out. He's dodgy. Threw it over to me. I've been sitting on the fence all day with this, and I'm going to say Lewis on the 180s.
Wow. It's going to be something special.
58. Might require 130.
And it's just moments away. 2011, Ladbrokes.com World Championship Final. Ball for Van Gerwen here. Chasing Aaron a break of throw. Now Aaron Monk on 164. This would be something special for the young man.
What he's got to do, Nige, he's just got to set it up. I used the word set up. He needs a treble. Puts pressure on Van Gerwen. He knows Van Gerwen. He's prone to missing doubles. Didn't really pressure the shot. So nice and fluent this should be. And it's exactly what it is. If he'd have put some real pressure, he might have made it just like he did the 12s.
That's a massive break and throw for Michael Van Gerwen with that finish. Averaging 87 now. You do get the feeling that if he does hit top form, he's capable of winning three legs on the spin to win the title here, Rod. But Aaron's a very tidy player. He'll just be disappointed, Aaron Monk, that he conceded a leg with the throw there, because he could almost see the finish line.
100.
Yeah, you're right. When you're in that commanding position, great players close the game out very quickly. But these are young men. Experience. There's no substitute for experience in any sport. Nige, you've been around sportsmen for a long time. That's exactly true. But I have to say, both players look very comfortable on that stage.
Yeah. Been around sport for a while, working in a professional capacity, but 61. This year's World Darts Championship has been one of the highlights for me. Certainly, it's been a tremendous occasion, and it's just going to get even better. Van Gerwen with a lovely turn 40, but Lewis and Anderson, a terrific final to look forward to, and an absolute privilege to be here to sample the atmosphere and the build-up and the match itself. We can't wait.
44.
No, we certainly can't. I think if Lewis comes out firing on all cylinders, he could get a good two sets up before Gary Anderson even blinks, to be 54. Quite honest. And that's what he's got to do.
Adrian's been threatening for so long. We are watching the World Under 21 final right now, Aaron Monk and Michael Van Gerwen. But Adrian Lewis has been threatening for a while. Since he beat Barney, of course, at Blackpool in a thriller and match play 4 years ago. It was a brilliant match, commentated with Sid on that one.
81.
And when you look at it, Adrian finally reaching a world final and doing himself justice. But will he prevail, or will it be Gary Anderson to be crowned world champion tonight?
I think the difference in 80 from, say, the Grand Prix knowledge, I think he's learned. He's grown up, you know, he's learned a bit of respect and discipline in himself to think, well, I can do this. As Van Gerwen now goes to 32, double eight, into with his third dart.
Look what it means to him, levels the match, four apiece. And basically now it's best of three legs to win the World Under 21 title. The World Final itself, Lewis and Anderson coming up in around a quarter of an hour or so.
100.
They're in the practice room, getting set. One of the most eagerly awaited world finals from a number of years. No Phil Taylor this year, but my word, the final is going to be every bit the spectacle that we expect. High standard of play, toe-to-toe, and at first to seven sets will be crowned world champion.
Yep, the nerves are going to be flying about down in that practice room at the moment. You know, you're going from, if you miss a double, when you're having a practice and going, oh, I'm not going to do that at the stage, to hitting the 180, you go, I'm going to hit plenty of them. It really is a roller coaster emotional ride for these guys at the moment. But when they get on that stage, Nige, it's all defined. Defined, I should say. You know, total concentration, and there they are in the practice room.
A lot of it is a mental state, isn't it? Because it's their first world final. So, you know, a lot of that in terms of how they prepared from the moment they got out of bed this morning. It's a big day for them.
They were on the same dartboard. In any other sport, you wouldn't see that very often, would you? You know, I wouldn't want to do that, so I wouldn't want to look at what he's hit.
Well, this one nicely poised. Aaron Monk was in a good position to go on and win this. And could still do so. Whatever happens, we know that we'll have no more than 100. Three legs to decide this
Aaron
now.
By 121.
He's got 121. He's the treble 18. It's a strange way of going. You practice on that treble 20 all day, and he goes with the treble 17. But obviously, he knows more than me. Bullseye. Oh, yes! What a great shot!
121 for Aaron Monk to check out and go within a leg on the under 21 world title. Well done, that man. And now, pressure on mighty Michael van Gerwen.
60.
Well, 71% Aaron Monk has on his finishes. And I tell you what, there's any top professional. The two in the final, Lewis or Anderson, will be over the moon with 71%.
Absolutely right. 82.5 average. Whatever happens now, this match has only got a maximum of two more legs to run before we bring on Lewis and Anderson for the world final itself. Van Gerwen has to hold his throw to take us into a deciding leg.
Well, a massive charge here for young Aaron. A 140, that's what he'd be looking for. Give him control of the leg. That's a beautiful dart. Should lay this one on top of that. Plenty of room there for the third night. We can hit it from here, can we? Oh.
125.
5-1 for a 9-darter in the world final. How many times last night in the semi-finals did we see players on a 9-darter after, what, 5-6 darts? I couldn't quite finish it off. Don't put it past one of these boys to do one tonight in the final.
Well, Adrian Lewis to throw the 9-darter, 12-1. I can remember when Ladbrokes would give you 50-1 for a player. That's how much the standard has improved.
Van Gerwen in a spot of bother here, but this is nice recovery. Oh, it's the first time that's happened to him. Aaron Monk's had a couple of bounce outs in this match. That was heading for a 180. Van Gerwen still on a finish. Now, Monk looking to set himself up for the best finish possible. Two in here.
What a time to put a maximum in. Van Gerwen had his third dart ball left and left him on 104. So now Aaron Monk, 67, to become the Unicorn Youth World Champion. Start a real illustrious career in this sport. Double eight.
World under 21 title, double four! Aaron Monk is the new PDC Unicorn World under 21 champion! Congratulations to him! It's success for the Englishman now tonight against the Dutchman.